Welcome viewers, welcome to Subhas Biology. We are here to discuss about human reproduction. And today's topic is human reproduction. Let's start. Humans are sexually reproducing organisms, and they are viviparous and they are unisexual organisms. That is, male and female sexes are separate and each sex has reproductive organs, reproductive ducts and accessory structures. The reproductive events in humans include gametogenesis, insemination, fertilization, implantation, embryonic development and parturition. And these events occur after puberty. There are remarkable differences between the reproductive events in males and females. And in this chapter, we'll study about the different reproductive systems in male and female and also the various events of human reproduction. Let's start. As I told you, the human beings show prominent sexual dimorphism. Sexual dimorphism means what? Both the sexes are separate. That means male and female both are separate from each other. Their morphology is different. And by number of this sexual dimorphism that occurs due to a number of primary and secondary sex characters. And what is primary sex characters? The primary sex characters are those which are present since birth in both males and females, like external genitalia. That is called as primary sex characters. And what is secondary sex characters? Secondary sex character appears after puberty and includes a number of characters like presence of thick facial hairs, low pitch voice in males, and well-developed mammary gland in high-pitched voice in females. And in case of a male also, they have mammary gland, but that mammary gland which is rudimentary in nature. But in case of female, that is highly effective and functional. And reproductive organs are divided into two types. Number one, primary sex organ, and number two, secondary sex organs. Primary sex organ, these are the organs that produce gametes and sex hormones. And secondary sex organs are the organs, they play important role during reproduction, but they doesn't secrete any sex hormones. Now we discuss the male reproductive system in detail. The male reproductive system, which is located inside the pelvis region. The pelvis region means the pelvic girdle. It is present at the hip region, and the space occupied by this pelvic girdle, that is called as pelvis region. And inside the pelvis region, that contain male reproductive system, or male reproductive system which is present or located in the pelvis region. And this male reproductive system that includes primary sex organs and secondary sex organs. Primary sex organs that include pair of testes, and secondary sex organs that include accessory ducts, accessory glands and external genitalia. And these accessory ducts that include retro testes, epididymis, vasa deferentia, urethra, these all are accessory ducts. And accessory glands that include seminal vesicles, prostate gland, seminal vesicle, prostate gland and bulbourethral gland, or bulbourethral gland also called as Cowper's gland. And these are responsible for the lubrication of the penis. And external genitalia also called as copulatory organ. And this copulatory organ is penis. And one by one we'll discuss. This is male reproductive structure, and this is testis. Pair of testes are there, and this is penis, and this one is the center one is urethra, and these small structures are called as Cowper's gland or bulbourethral gland, and this one is prostate gland, and this is seminal vesicles, pair of seminal vesicles are there, and this is ejaculatory, this one is ejaculatory duct, and this is vas deferens, and this is spermatic cord, and this one is epididymis, and this is all about male reproductive structure. And one by one we'll discuss. First of all, we discuss about the primary sex organ, that is testis. In case of male, they have pair of testes, and both the testes that located outside the abdominal cavity within a pouch, and that is called as scrotum. And scrotum that provide the low temperature, that is 2 to 2.5 degrees low temperature as compared to the internal body temperature, and this low temperature which is required for the spermatogenesis. For spermatogenesis, the body of the spermatogenesis process that needs 2 degree less temperature as per the internal body temperature. And testes are suspended in the scrotum by tube like structure, and that tube is called as spermatic cord. And each testis, that is about 4 to 5, the length of the testis, this is testis, and the length of the testis is 4 to 5 cm, and the width of the testis, which is 2 to 3 cm. And each testis is surrounded by membrane, and that membrane is called as tunica albuginea. This is tunica albuginea. This one is tunica albuginea, the outer membrane of the testis, that is called as tunica albuginea. And this tunica albuginea, which is surround the compartments of the testis, and this tunica albuginea again surrounded by tunica vaginalis. And inside the tunica albuginea that contains 250 compartments, these are compartments, this black compartment, these are the compartments, and these compartments are called as testicular lobule. These are called as testicular lobules. And these all lobules, one lobule that separates from another lobule by the help of one membrane or partition, and that partition is called as septum. And inside each testicular lobule that contains highly convoluted 2 to 3 seminiferous tubules. And this seminiferous tubule is the structural and functional unit of testis. And this seminiferous tubule again drawn to the again end to a tube-like structure, and that is called as retro testis. And this this one is tubuli seminiferi or tubuli recti, and this tubuli recti again open to the retro testis, and again retro testis that open to the vas efferentia. And this vas efferentia again open to the epididymis, which is lying to the testis. And this epididymis is responsible for the storage of sperm for 2 to 3 days, that is approximately for 72 hours. And epididymis, which is divided into 3 parts, one is head, this is head, and this one is body, and last one is tail. The body of the epididymis also called as caputo epididymis, and the head of the epididymis is called as caputo epididymis, and the body of the epididymis is called as corpus epididymis, and the tail of the epididymis is called as caudo epididymis. These are the 3 parts of the epididymis, and this epididymis is responsible for the storage of the sperm for 2 to 3 days, that is 72 hours, up to 72 hours. And this epididymis again thrown into a tube, and that tube is called as vas efferentia. This one is vas deferentia, and this vas deferentia again open to a tube-like structure, and that is called as spermatic cord. Both the testes are suspended inside the scrotal sac or scrotum through a tube-like structure, and this tube is called as, by the help of a tube, and that tube is called as spermatic cord. The spermatic cord that carry the testis which is that carry the testes for those in the suspended condition inside the scrotum. But the testes which is originate inside the abdomen of the fetus. Initially वो क्या होता है, फिटस के अंदर, जो एब्डोमेन के अंदर, ड्यूरिंग द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ द फिटस अप टू 7 मंथ द टेस्टिस विच इज रिमेन इनसाइड द एब्डोमेन ऑफ द फिटस, बट एट 7 मंथ द टेस्टिस विच डिसेंट इनटू द स्क्रोटम. मतलब 7 मंथ तक फिटस का एब्डोमेन में वो रहता है, 7 मंथ के बाद 7 मंथ में क्या हो रहा है, वो टेस्टिस नीचे आ रहा है. किसके नीचे, किसके अंदर आ रहा है, स्क्रोटम के अंदर आ रहा है. दैट इज कॉल्ड एज डिसेंडिंग ऑफ द टेस्टिस इनटू द स्क्रोटम. अबाउट दिस आल्सो वी डिस्कस. नाउ वी डिस्कस व्हाट इज स्क्रोटम. स्क्रोटम इट इज ए पाउच लाइक स्ट्रक्चर एंड दिस पाउच लाइक स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ पिगमेंटेड स्किन अराइजिंग फ्रॉम द लोअर एब्डोमिनल वॉल and hanging between two legs, and it is divided internally. This is scrotal sac, and it is a pouch like pigmented skin, and that is called as scrotum or scrotal sac, and it is present between two legs. And this scrotum, the divided into internally, the divided into two part, one is right and right scrotal sac and left scrotal sac. And this right and left scrotal sac that are divided by or separated from each other by the help of muscular partition, and that muscular partition is called as septum scrota. This wall is called as septum scrota. And the testes originate in the abdominal cavity, but later during the 7 months of the development of embryo, that descend into the respective scrotal sac. मतलब यहाँ पर जब फीटस का डेवलपमेंट हो रहा है, ये एब्डोमेन है, ये एब्डोमेन में इधर है राइट साइड का जो टेस्टिस, एंड ये है लेफ्ट साइड का टेस्टिस. एंड both the testes, this is the right side testes and this is right side and this is left side. And up to 6 months and both the testes that remain inside the abdomen. But at 7 months, both the testes that fall on the inside into the scrotum through a canal or passage, and that passage is called as inguinal canal. This is inguinal canal. And by the help of or through this passage or inguinal canal, the testes, right testes that are descend into the right scrotal sac, and the left testes that are descend into the left scrotal sac. And if the testes is unable to descend, then that cause a condition, and that condition is called as cryptorchidism. The undescended testes that leads to a condition, and that is called as cryptorchidism. And this cryptorchidism later on that leads to infertility. It is the dangerous cause, but that is rare. Next is the scrotum that contains muscle, specialized muscle, and this muscle is responsible for the lowering of the temperature, that is 2 to 2.5 degree temperature. This is all about your, and this 2 to 2.5 degree less temperature that essential for the production of a sperm or spermatogenesis. This is all about scrotum, and this one is the scrotum, and inside the scrotum testes is present. Now we'll discuss the seminiferous tubule, the unit of the structural and functional unit of testes. And seminiferous tubule, it is the place that produce sperm. And seminiferous tubule, which is present inside the testicular lobule. Each testicular lobule that contains 2 to 3 seminiferous tubule, and this one is one seminiferous tubule, and this is another seminiferous tubule, and this one is another seminiferous tubules. The minimum is 2 and maximum is 3. And these seminiferous tubules that lie by two te- types of cells. One is male germ cell, another one is Sertoli cell. The male germ cell, also called as spermatogonia or sperm mother cell, and Sertoli cell is also called as no cells, because the Sertoli cell that provide nourishment to the sperm and that responsible for the differentiation of the spermatid into sperms. That's it. These Sertoli cell also called as no cells. And male germ cells, these are cuboidal cells, cube like structures are there, and these cuboidal cells are called as male germ cell or spermatogonia. Singular spermatogonium, plural spermatogonia. And these spermatogonia sperm mother cell undergoes meiosis and they produce spermatid. And after formation of a spermatid, that spermatid which enter into the pyramidal shaped cell, that is called a Sertoli cell, and inside the Sertoli cell, the differentiation of the spermatid occur to form mature spermatozoa, and that process is called as spermiogenesis. Or the conversion of a spermatid into mature sperm occurs inside the Sertoli cell, and these are pyramidal shaped cells. And these Sertoli cells secrete two types of protein, that is androgen binding protein, another one is inhibin. Androgen binding protein or ABP, which is responsible for the conversion of spermatid into mature sperm or spermatozoa, and inhibin that suppresses the FSH follicle stimulating hormone of anterior pituitary. In between seminiferous tables, there is a space, and that space is called as interstitial space. And this interstitial space that contains some irregular shaped cells. These small cells are called as irregular shaped cells, and these irregular shaped cells are called as interstitial cell or Leydig cells. These are called as Leydig cell or interstitial cell. And these interstitial cells that secrete one hormone, and that hormone is called as androgen or testosterone, and it is the male sex hormone, and that is responsible for the spermatogenesis. This is all about seminiferous tubule. Now we'll discuss about accessory ducts. The accessory ducts that include tubuli recti, tubuli recti, retrotestis, vasa efferentia, and epididymis, vas deferens, and urethra. Vasa efferentia, that also called as intratesticular ducts, because this vasa efferentia that is present inside the testis, that's why that is called as intratesticular ducts. And vas deferens that is present outside the testis, that's why that is called as extratesticular ducts. And end of the seminiferous tubules converge and join to form short straight tubules, and that is called as tubuli recti. And this tubuli recti again run through the retrotestis, and this retrotestis again open into vasa efferentia, and this vasa efferentia leave the testis and open into epididymis, and then epididymis leads to vas deferens, and that ascends to the abdomen through inguinal canal and loops over the urinary bladder. And vas deferens receives a duct from seminal vesicle and open into urethra as a ejaculatory duct. The vas deferens from after seminal vesicle up to urethra, that is called as ejaculatory duct. Vas deferens and ejaculatory duct both are same tube, but after seminal vesicle, that is named as ejaculatory duct. And urethra originates from the urinary bladder and extends through the penis to its external opening, that is called as urethral meatus. Let's see. This is seminiferous tubule. This one is, these are the, this is, each lobule is called a testicular lobule, and inside each testicular lobule that contain 2 to 3 seminiferous tubules, and end of the seminiferous tubule, that is a straight tube is there, and that straight tubes are called as tubuli recti. And this tubuli recti that open to the retrotestis, this is, this person is called as retrotestis, and this retrotestis again open to tube, and these tubes are called as vasa efferentia or intratesticular ducts, and these vasa efferentia again open into the epididymis or open outside the testis, and that is epididymis. And if it is from the epididymis, this epididymis again open to around to ascending duct or tube, and that is called as vas deferens. And this vas deferens again come to the or run towards the seminal vesicles, and again from seminal vesicles that opens to the ejaculatory duct, then to the urethra. That means inside the seminiferous tubule sperms are formed, and after formation of a sperm inside the seminiferous tubule, this sperm that moves toward the tubule recti, then to the retrotestis, then to vasa efferentia, and then to epididymis. And inside the epididymis that may store for 2 to 3 days or up to 72 hours, and then from epididymis that moves towards the vas deferens, and then from vas deferens that moves towards the ejaculatory duct, then urethra, and at the ejaculation time that comes outside. And up to seminiferous tubule the sperm only moves, but when that reaches at the seminiferous tubule, when that reaches at the seminal vesicle, then the seminal fluid that combine with the sperm, and seminal fluid or seminal plasma along with the sperm that moves toward the prostate gland and again to the Cowper's gland, and after that forms the semen, and this semen that comes outside during the ejaculation. This is all about the pathway of the sperm movement from the seminiferous tubule outside the body. Now we discuss about accessory glands. The accessory glands in male reproductive system that includes pair of seminal vesicles, a prostate gland, and pair of bulbo-urethral gland, or it is also called as Cowper's gland. Now we discuss seminal vesicles. Seminal vesicles, they secrete mucus and watery alkaline fluid, and that contain fructose, and which acts as an energy source for sperm that provide energy for the sperm motility. And fructose, it is the only carbohydrate which is present inside the male, and the fructose is not present elsewhere in the body. Therefore, during forensic test for RAF, its presence in female genitalia tract or vagina that confirm the sexual intercourse, and that called the egophthalmia of the rapist. And prostaglandins and clotting protein forms a temporary clot after ejaculation, and it stimulates uterine contraction for sperm movement. That means prostaglandin that also increase the sperm motility. And this seminal, whatever the secretion that secretes from the seminal vesicles, this is called a seminal plasma. And this seminal plasma that constitutes 70% of the semen. And next is prostate gland. Below the seminal vesicle, the prostate gland is there, and it is a single gland, and it secretes milky, slightly alkaline fluid, and that contains lipid, enzyme, citric acid, etc. And these are released during ejaculation and helps to neutralize the acidic medium of vagina and making sperms more active to swim. The neutralization of the vagina that occurs due to the prostatic fluid, whatever the fluid that secrete from the prostate gland, that is called as prostatic fluid. And this prostatic fluid that cause the neutralization of acidic medium of vagina. And this prostatic fluid that accounts for nearly 20-30% of semen volume. Next is bulbo-urethral gland or Cowper's gland. Cowper's gland, pair of Cowper's gland present at the base of the penis, that means this is the penis. And the base of the penis that contains a pair of gland, and that gland is called as bulbo-urethral gland or Kupper's gland, and above the Kupper's gland, prostate gland is there, and both the sides of the prostate gland at the above that contain the seminal vesicles, and these secrete mucus and alkaline fluid into the urethra. This Kupper's gland that secrete mucus and alkaline fluid into the urethra. This one is urethra, and the mucus helps in the lubrication of the penis and neutralize any urinary acids in urethra. Whatever the acid is there inside the urethra, then these mucus that secrete from the Kupper's gland that cause the neutralization of the urethra. And the secretion of the mucus from the Kupper's gland or bulbourethral gland that cause the itchy intercourse and that prevent from the friction. And these are situated beneath the bladder. Okay, this is bladder. And beneath the bladder that contain the both the Kupper's glands are there, and behind the urethra. This is all about the three accessory glands of the male reproductive system. Then semen is the final product of the three glands, secretion of the three glands. Semen, the secretion of the accessory glands and mucus, and when added, then that form the added with the sperm, then that form the seminal fluid or semen. Seminal plasma and mucus, when combined with sperm, which comes from the seminiferous tubule, then that form the seminal fluid or semen. And this semen that constitutes 70% seminal plasma and 20% prostate gland, and only 10% semen. And this semen, what are the secretions I have, what are the functions of these secretions? They provide, this also different function, such as they provide medium for transmission of sperms and nourish and activate the sperms to keep them viable and motile. This secretion that provide medium for the transmission of the sperm, when the sperm that enters into the ejaculatory duct, which comes from the seminiferous tubule, then when that reaches at the seminal vesicle, then that gets nourishment and that provide energy for the transmission, because the seminal vesicle that contains fructose, and this fructose that provide the energy for the motility of the movement of the sperm. And nourish, and it also nourishes the sperm and activates the sperm to keep them viable and motile. That means for the movement, that are responsible for the movement of the sperm. Next is, in case of a semen, another one is zinc is there. In case of a semen, zinc, it is the element which is one of the component of the semen is zinc, and this element which is present inside the semen. But till now, it is a big question of how and where the zinc comes to the semen. It is still unknown. But its concentration below certain level has been associated with infertility. Whatever the concentration or certain level of the zinc is there, if that zinc level that becomes low or any imbalance occurs, then that calls the infertility. But we don't know from where the zinc comes into the semen, and which gland or which part of the male reproductive structure that secretes the zinc. It is unknown till now. This is all about the accessory duct, accessory glands, and about the testis. Now we discuss external genitalia. The external genitalia of the male, that is penis, and it is made of special tissue that helps for the erection of the penis and the facilitate insemination. And what is the erection of penis? The erection of a penis that occurs due to the some erectile muscle or tissue, and this erectile tissue that include corpus spongiosum and corpus cavernosa. This corpus, the light pink structures, these are corpus spongiosum, and this corpus spongiosum, these are mass of spongy tissue which surrounds urethra and involves in erection by allowing the rushing of blood into it. That means corpus spongiosum that contain the blood vascular system or blood vessels, and when sexual urge occur, then that cause the heavy supply of the blood into the corpus spongiosum, and that cause the erection of the penis. And corpus cavernosa also surrounds the corpus spongiosum, and this is corpus cavernosa. This outer membrane is corpus cavernosa, and this is also sponge like region of and this also responsible for the erection of the penis, and which contains most of the blood in the penis during penile erection, and this also vascular in nature. And during the sexual urge, that heavy supply of the blood occurs into this erectile tissue, and that cause the erection of the penis. And the tip of the penis that contains an enlarged end, and this enlarged end is called as glans penis. And this glans penis, which is covered by folding, a loose folded skin, and this loose folded skin is called as foreskin. That is called as foreskin. This foreskin and glans penis, it is a highly sensitive part of the male reproductive system. The sensitive part of the male is glans penis. And this is all about the male reproductive system. Thank you. Please subscribe my channel.